What exactly is biohacking and can it make you limitless? Let's find out. Hey, what's up? Greg here, the founder of Your Inception. Welcome to my channel where I share you how you can achieve limitless performance with a minimalistic approach. Subscribe below to start your journey. Today, we're gonna talk about biohacking. What is biohacking? Why is it important for you? And I'm gonna share with you some of the best, most effective biohacks that you can easily implement in your daily life. First thing first, when I talk to people about biohacking, a lot of them think about tools and strategies and apps and whatnot, you know, stuff that would help you achieve unhuman-like performance, you know. They think about sensors that you put in your body, they think about, you know, different stuff that would help you see, experience, feel, different stuff that people right now cannot do it. Now, I'm not saying biohacking is not that. Actually, I know some biohackers from Finland, from the States as well, that have different sensors in their body. They can see infrared light, for example. They can, you know, hear sounds from, I don't know, 100 to 200 meters away, and so on. I mean, this is ridiculous stuff. It's really extraordinary things that you can do with your body nowadays. But in general, I mean, I believe we are still not there. I mean, you can do a lot of stuff with your body nowadays, but biohacking in general is something else. Or at least before you even try to do this amazing stuff with your body, you try to, you know, take care of the fundamentals or the foundation, and that's the most important thing. So I see biohacking, or at least, you know, where we are right now, about getting to 100%. So we are right now performing at, I don't know, 50%, 75%. So some of you have a better performance, some of you have a worse performance, and you know, I believe no one is at 100%, so this would mean that everything is completely optimized. So what biohacking can help you is to get to 100%, or at least to get to as close to 100% as possible. And that's why, you know, when we talk about biohacking, we actually talk about five main areas. These are nutrition, sleep, work, mind, and exercise. And under each of these five areas, you have many different tools, you have different strategies, different tricks that you can implement in your everyday life, and they will, or they should, help you perform better. So let's just go into those areas, and I'll try to share with you some of the best, some of the most efficient and effective biohacks that I implement in my life, and they help me achieve amazing performance. So first, nutrition. Now, I don't want to go too much into details here. I just want to give you kind of a brief overview, so you have the ideas, you get the basic know-how, understanding. So when it comes to nutrition, I mean, there are different kind of diets, like ketogenic diet, like paleo diet, like vegan diet. All of them are right now very popular. And when it comes to nutrition related to biohacking, it's really about which of these diets is the most beneficial for your health, can help you perform the best in the long term, and also give you the short-term benefits. So more importantly than, you know, choosing one kind of diet and sticking to it is, you know, experimenting a bit and finding what works the best for you. That's the most important part. Now, then we have, for example, intermittent fasting. That's what I do, and that's what I recommend doing. So I usually don't eat breakfast. I skip breakfast for many reasons. One of them is because I feel much better in the morning, my mind works better, and the recovery process is much more optimized. So you know, if you don't eat for a longer period, then you should be healthier in the long term. That's what recent studies show. So I follow the 16-8 routine, which means I don't eat for 16 hours. This includes, you know, the whole night that I sleep, basically. And then, you know, a couple of hours during the day, of course, I skip breakfast. And then I have this 8-hour period in which I generally eat, you know, whatever I want to. I stick to mainly plant-based diet. And this, you know, for me works the best right now. So yeah, intermittent fasting is another thing. Then, for example, if you're intolerant to gluten, to milk, so to lactose and so on, you know, these are different stuff that you have to figure out for yourself that, you know, are causing issues, are causing inflammation. And because of this inflammation, you have brain fog, you cannot focus, your sleep sucks, you have no energy. And as soon as you start optimizing this, you're gonna see better results. The second area is sleep. Now, when it comes to sleep, sleep is important for recovery. This is the most important thing to remember. Sleep is crucial for recovery. Of course, during sleep, other things happen, like memory formation and so on. But the main thing you have to have in your mind is recovery. So how can you optimize your sleep to achieve better results and hopefully or potentially sleep shorter? Well, one of the things you can do is you can track sleep cycles. Now, I don't want to talk about sleep cycles in this video, but in general, just that you know, you go through different kind of steps or cycles for each night, and what happens is, if you are waking up in the wrong phase of your sleep, you're gonna be all grudgy and we will have no energy. And if you optimize your sleep according to your sleep cycles, what's gonna happen is your sleep will be better. This means your recovery will be faster and you will wake up with more energy. So you can track your sleep. You can use different tools like Oura Ring, for example. There are like Fitbit trackers. You can use your smartphone. You can put it on your pillow and so on. And of course, another thing that you can do is, you know, general sleep optimization. There are a lot of stuff I do. So a couple of tricks that I recommend is making your room as dark as possible, avoiding any kind of artificial light 2 hours before sleep. So if you use smartphones and iPads and shit, you know, just put them away. Then making your room kind of a cold, not too cold, but you know, kind of a cold, like around 17, 18, up to 20 degrees Celsius. I don't know how much is that in Fahrenheit. Well, but yeah, you'll get it anyway, you can check it out. Then make your room as quiet as possible. That's also important. And of course, you can use supplements, you can use certain nootropics that can help you optimize your sleep as well. The third area is mind. Now, mind is important for productivity, all right? If your mind is as it should be, so optimized, then of course, you will be able to focus, you'll be able to have the energy or to get the energy, you'll be able to work for hours and hours and hours, you'll be you know, quick in thinking, and you know, a lot of great things will happen basically. Now, how can you get mind working properly? Well, there are a lot of stuff you can do. For example, morning or evening meditation. I do recommend meditating for about 5 to 10 minutes every single morning. This really helps me out a lot. Then I of course recommend taking nootropics and nootropic supplements. That they really help me out a lot to, you know, stay in the game all the time and to be able to perform on such level that I'm currently performing. Then of course you have the gratitude. You can write, you know, your daily gratitude basically in your diary every single morning, you know, every single evening, whatever you want. You know, you just write down stuff that happened to you that you're happy for, you know, during the day. And this should, you know, help you out perform on a high level in the long term. And that's a very easy biohack that you can instantly implement in your life. Of course, if you want to perform even better, you can do a psychoanalysis, or you go to a psychiatrist or psychologist, basically, that's even better, and do some more advanced trainings. And, you know, then there's a lot of other stuff, but those are kind of the basic things that you should know about. The fourth area is work. So you need to optimize your workspace, your working habits, you know, that you can really become productive, that you can really optimize your work, that you can do a lot of stuff in the short period. And that's kind of the important thing here. So a lot of stuff that can be done. A couple of tricks that I use is I turn off my smartphone, I turn off all notifications, I don't read email every couple of hours, I don't check social media channels and that kind of stuff. These are like kind of the basic stuff you can do immediately, but they're really, really effective, you know, really effective. Then of course, you can set up a special morning habit or morning routine. That's even more important, that, you know, once you wake up, you do certain steps, like you meditate, you take a cold shower, you, you know, drink your morning coffee or a cup of green or black tea, whatever you like. And then your mind will kind of make this, you know, it's gonna remember the whole pattern, and you know, it's gonna know that after your morning routine is finished, you're gonna start working, and then you need all the power, all the, you know, performance focus into your work. And you know, that's what you can do as well. That's another biohack that you can easily implement in your daily life. By the way, guys, if you like the video, don't forget to press the like button below. I'll be super happy about it. Last but not least, there is exercise. So when it comes to exercise, it's not about getting bigger, you know, having these big muscles and, you know, not being able to walk and that kind of stuff. And it's also not about winning the Olympic gold medal or whatever. It's more about achieving optimal performance, you know, with minimum effort from you, all right? It's about being fast. It's about being agile. It's about being lean, you know, it's about being strong. It's about having the stamina, you know? That's the important part. That's what biohacking is. One of the, you know, tricks or biohacks that I use is I train 3 times a week. As you can see, I'm not really a big guy, but I'm very fast and very lean. I feel very well in my body. I do have a certain training procedure, but all my trainings are pretty short, like 40 to 45 minutes. And that's kind of the way I hacked exercise. This exercise helps me to, you know, stay on top of my game, you know? So those are kind of the 5 main areas of biohacking. And, you know, I shared a lot of different, you know, stuff that you can immediately implement in your daily life. So are you currently doing any of the stuff that I mentioned? If yes, what exactly are you doing? Let me know in the comment section below. So yeah, we just covered top 5 main areas of biohacking. We explained why is biohacking important for you, what you can do if you include certain biohacks in your body. Now in the next videos, I'm gonna share with you certain biohacks more in detail, so you'll be able to dramatically optimize your life to really achieve limitless performance with your minimal effort. So if you like this video and if you wanna learn more, do subscribe to this channel. If you have any questions, do let me know. Don't forget to follow Your Inception on Facebook and Instagram. And guys, I hope to see you soon. Take care.